I'm here with Ryan Meza. He's holding the latest issue of Ring Magazine, and he can't wait to read it. And the first thing he reads is the letters to the editor. Read that letter that you wanted to read.
So we were just discussing right now, you know, because Ronda Rousey was on the cover of Ring Magazine not too long ago.
She's a very talented fighter. She's a good...
Yeah, she is. No one's saying that she isn't talented, you know, but, you know, this happened right before she got knocked out against Holly Holm, you know, so basically her, I guess you could say her aura of invincibility, you know, this happened and that happened and then so that's gone, you know, but so anyways, there's a letter to Ring Magazine regarding that from a Ken Renwood in Melbourne, Australia. It says, not pleased. As a subscriber to the Ring Magazine for over 50 years, this is the first time I have written to you. Ronda Rousey on the front cover is a disgrace. This is a boxing magazine, not a UFC magazine. UFC is barbaric, allowing a fighter that has been knocked down to be continually hit by their opponent, as demonstrated in the latest Rousey fight. Where is the sport in that? I guess justice was done by the fact that this woman was knocked out here in Melbourne. Good riddance.
Hard. Did they respond when people write, like in other magazines, like Mad Magazine, where the editor responds to the letters, like with a sarcastic answer? Like, screw you, it's our magazine, we'll put anybody we want on the cover? Or they just leave it alone?
They left it alone. They didn't put any response to it, from what I understand.
But it's their magazine. They could put whoever they want on the cover.
Yeah, but hey, you know what? Ring Magazine, okay, all the letters they get, they didn't even have to put that. But
that's
they
true.
Did.
So I give them respect for that.
Yeah.
Even though it makes them look like, hey, why'd you do it? But... if you could put a fighter on a cover of Ring Magazine that has not been there yet, who would you do? Who would get?
That's a good question.
Mikey Garcia, talking about the business of boxing, how he hasn't fought in 2 years.
That would be a very, very interesting article right there for sure, you know. That's a good one. Let's see, who else? Has Chocolatito been on the cover yet?
I don't know. I think so. They're one of those like four faces on, you know.
But we're like talking like solo shots.
Yeah, so probably not. No, not yet.
He'd be a good one. Let's see who else that I haven't seen yet that I can think of.
Tyson Fury.
That'd be an interesting article right there and story right there.
Amir Khan. Has he been on the cover by himself?
I don't think I've seen him on the cover by himself.
I've seen Canelo.
But I've seen him on. I've seen
Mayweather
share the cover.
Yeah,
he's shared the cover.
So has Triple G. No, Triple G's been on the cover.
Triple G's had his own solo cover. Yes. Yeah. Danny Garcia had his own solo cover as well. Yeah. Lucas Matisse has had his own solo.
B-Hop cover. Has had him as an alien. I've seen that.
Of course, you know. I believe Ward has as well too. There's the fighters out there. I think has Sergey Kovalev had one of his own?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, okay, absolutely. Yeah, all right. Yeah. I mean, that's the thing about Ring Magazine. They pump out so many issues, sometimes it's hard to keep up with all.
Once every 2 months, one issue.
I don't know.
Once a month?
I don't know. I think it's, I don't know.
I used to get it. I don't get it anymore, but I think I used to get it once every 6 weeks.
Well, one thing I do know is that they date their issues way further.
That's
ahead
true.
Of time.
No, they do. They write them and they publish them like a month before you get them.
Well, for example, okay, this is March 2016. It's not even March yet. It's February.
Yeah, but that's,
right now,
that's
but that's what I mean.
That's the March issue.
Yeah, but that's every magazine that is in existence. They always do that.
But magazines are dying.
Yeah, but I'm just saying that's a thing that's always been done. Like, take the original Superman, June 1938, but it didn't come out in June 1938. It came out months before.
Like April or March or something.
Yeah, that's just magazines. That's just how they do it. Mm. You know what I mean? So
I can't do that. If I shoot a video, it has to be up right now. Like, by the time I'm done with this video, it's going to be on YouTube. Like, imagine if I did this now and I uploaded it in 3 months.
That's the power of technology, man. You got that
social media.
You got that advanced these days. Where back then, they had to write it and print it.
That's true.
Make up additional copies. Yeah.
There used to be KO Magazine. There used to be USA Boxing Magazine. Yeah. Right now, I think this is the only magazine that we have here in the U.S. There are a few in England still.
Yeah, magazines are dying because one of my favorite all-time magazines, BMX Plus, just ended after 38 years. And again, it's just, you know, nobody's buying. And the other thing is you go to places that are hard to find anyway. Like certain magazines that you want, they're hard to find.
Everything's online, Coach. It's not the same online because you can't appreciate a picture like in a magazine.
I know. Having a magazine.
Where you go, read it,
my hand, I can read it. You know,
not have to look for Wi-Fi where you go.
You know, there's a little bit more of an authenticity to looking at a newspaper or reading a magazine or something like that. You know, I mean,
yeah.
Like
but we live in the Technology.
We're in the technological age now. That's the thing, you know.
So by afternoon, you already read 10 newspapers, 3 websites. Where here, you have 1 magazine, and you know what I mean? Like the way we think these days.
Yeah, but sometimes, you know, like, okay, say for example, you got a magazine right here. You know, you read it from beginning to end, almost like a book, right?
Right.
You know, you feel a little bit more accomplished in that sense when you do something like that, as opposed to just reading one simple little article online.
Okay, here's a question for you guys: should I write a book about boxing? From my perspective, what I've seen in the last 6-7 years. You think
it'll
so?
Help, bro.
What should I call it? Give me a good title.
Let's see. Where's that one boxing book that we have?
You from behind the camera.
Reporting.
That's a good title.
All right, I'm doing it. I'm writing a book. Stories that were never told. The real behind the scenes.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah. That'd be an interesting one. You said it yourself, man. You've got a lot of stories. The stories that people don't know.
And, they don't know.
That'd be interesting.
All right, there you have it. Ryan Meza, Coach Dion, right here at Outlaw. Stay tuned for EsNews.com. I'm Alexi back reporting. So let me ask you this. Have you ever written a letter to Ring? Did they ever piss you off so bad that you took the time to say, I've been a reader for 50 years, and this is the first time I'm writing you?
No, I'll just read other guys' complaints, see what they say, and if I agree with what the guy's complaining about, I will, and if I don't, then I don't. You know, I don't feel the need. Yeah, me personally, like, I got time to do other things. I got to put my energy into other things. I don't have to invest that time and my energy that I'm like so angry about it that I have to send them a letter. I mean, shit, I can send them an email on there if I want to now, but that's not me. I don't do that.
All right, Coach Dion, have you ever sent a letter to the editor of Ring?
Not the Ring. One other BMX Plus, but
yeah, but that's it.
I think that was the only letter like that I've ever sent to the editor. My brother though. My brother, he's a huge comic book guy, and he's been reading comic books since he was 9. So but over the years, he's written a few letters to.
And they published them.
And they published his letters in those particular comics. I don't know. He has those comics, but I've never seen them. But he's done that. But there's no lack of time. It's just, you know, I'm like, because they never do anything that I like, you know, care so much about that I'm gonna write in, like. You mentioned Mad Magazine. I should write into them because it sucked so badly for like the last.
They've fallen. The second, you know what their key was? They never had advertisement. Never.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And now they started doing ads, and it changed.
Not just the advertisement, but once they went to color as well.
Yeah.
So. But you know what, man? That one letter that we were talking about earlier in that issue about the Holly Holm Ronda Rousey fight. Honestly, that's an understandable case right there. I mean,
what the beef that having Ronda on the cover?
No. Well, part of that, and also the fact that the guy said that he's been subscribing to Ring Magazine for 50 years.
Yeah.
This is a guy who's been reading it for a long, long time. So to read something, a letter like that in the magazine as a fan tells me, you know, that's a justifiable reason.
Legit.
Yeah.
He probably collects all of them and put them on the wall, and he just didn't want Ronda Rousey on his wall of boxing.
He should do like they do in the Mayweather gym. Just put it in a frame, put a tape over it like that.
All right. What was his name again in Australia?
His name was...
Crocodile Dundee?
Nah, not that guy. I'll pull it up real quick. His name
All right.
is...
So Ryan Mesa says, do what Floyd does when he hits the speed bag. Take 2 tapes.
Ken Redwood. Ken. Australia.
Ken Redwood. There you have it. So don't get mad. FuseNewsPoint.com. I'm Elisek back reporting.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekback.